GCF. The greatest common factor. The factors are the numbers we multiply together to get another number. Let's take the numbers 12 and 18. 1 times 12 equals 12. 2 times 6 equals 12. And 3 times 4 equals 12. 1 times 18 equals 18. 2 times 9 equals 18. And 3 times 6 equals 18. So the list of factors of 12 includes 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. And the list of factors of 18 includes 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, and 18. The common factors of two numbers are the factors that exist in the list of factors of each number of them. The largest common factor is called the greatest common factor, GCF, or the greatest common divisor, GCD. So the greatest common factor, GCF, can be defined as the largest positive integer that is a divisor of two or more numbers. 1, 2, 3, and 6 are the common factors of 12 and 18. 6 is the greatest common factor of 12 and 18. The greatest common factor is used to simplify the fractions. To find the greatest common factor. 1. Find the prime factors of all the numbers together at the same time. Every time examine the divisibility rule of the smallest possible common prime number that is a divisor of all the given numbers. When there are no more common prime factors, start finding the prime factors as usual. 2. Multiply all the obtained common prime factors together. Example 1. Find the GCF of the following numbers, 12 and 6. Solution. We'll start by asking what's the smallest common prime number that is a divisor of both 12 and 6 at the same time? The answer is 2, and the results of divisions are 6 and 3 respectively. Now we will ask what's the smallest common prime number of 6 and 3. The answer is 3, and the results of divisions are 2 and 1 respectively. There are no common prime factors of 2 and 1, so now we'll find the prime factors as usual by examining the divisibility rule of the smallest possible prime number, which is 2, and the result of the division is 1. The other one will be written as is. Next step is to multiply all the obtained common prime factors together. The common prime factors of 12 and 6 are 2 and 3, so GCF equals 2 times 3, which equals 6. Example 2. Simplify the fraction 8 over 20. Solution. Both 8 and 20 are divisible by 2, and the results of divisions are 4 and 10 respectively. Both 4 and 10 are divisible by 2, and the results of divisions are 2 and 5 respectively. 2 is divisible by 2, and the result of the division is 1. But 5 is not divisible by 2, without remainder, so we'll write it as is. 5 is divisible by 5, and the result of the division is 1. GCF equals 2 times 2, which equals 4. So, 8 over 20 equals 8 divided by 4. Over 20 divided by 4, which equals 2 over 5. Another way to find the GCF is by finding the prime factorization of each number separately, then multiply all the common prime factors that have the lowest exponent. Example 3. Find the GCF of 24 and 84. Solution. 24 is divisible by 2, and the result of division is 12. 12 is divisible by 2, and the result of division is 6. 6 is divisible by 2, and the result of division is 3. 3 is divisible by 3, and the result of division is 1. And 84 is divisible by 2, and the result of division is 42. 42 is divisible by 2, and the result of division is 21. 21 is divisible by 3, and the result of division is 7. 7 is divisible by 7, and the result of division is 1. Prime factorization of 24 equals 2 cubed, times 3. And the prime factorization of 84 equals 2 squared, times 3 times 7. Therefore, GCF equals 2 squared, times 3, which equals 12. Or, by multiplying the common prime factors as follows. prime factorization of 24 equals 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. And a prime factorization of 84 equals 2 times 2 times 3 times 7. Therefore, GCF equals 2 times 2 times 3, which equals 12. Note: the GCF of prime numbers is 1. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, comment, and share.